Well, cue the fire. How'd you like that bounce today? You're like, bravo. That is not a bounce. And how about people still? You guys just won't let Kevin stop. And retail is just relentless. I feel like everyone is just Jim Cramer. What do we... Oh. Wait a minute, Jimmy. You said the bear market is over. And hold on. Let me find the clip of Jimmy. Here it is. Now, this was at the top. Like, almost at the very top. It was like, no, the bear market's over.
We are in some weird market that it's a bear market and no one called it as a bear. And I think the bear market is over.
Wow, and that's a big call. Brian Zelsky, react to that.
Brian?
Well, I think the bear market has been over for a while.
Yes, absolutely. I mean, the bear market is over. Unicorns poop ice cream. That's where ice cream comes from. The ones that look like that. Exactly, right from the sphincter. Don't ever, no. That is just wrong. But I guess if it's from a unicorn, you're okay. And actually, that one clip that I posted of Jimmy, Jimmy, that was March. It was actually February that I think he was like, bear market's over. In this video, I'm gonna show you that it is not, and we have a lot of more worser things to come in crypto too. But we will always have bounces, and right now is the sentiment. It's the worst ever. That's usually really good buying opportunities. I'm just saying, not for long term. And actually, this is a five times in a lifetime kind of opportunity. This was going back to 2005. See over there? 2005, we hit there. Then we got 2008. Yeah, that was a bloodbath. That was opportunity number one. 2010, so we got one, two, three. Hold on. QE, 2016, 4, 5, 6, 7. But this was a big one. Look at that. How do you get 1,750? We have not dropped below that since, 2008. And also, according to the VIX, which is, it's rolling. Hey kids. You haven't seen nothing yet. See, we got to get to a point where retail is like, that's it. You know what? The game's over. I am out. Sell. I am never going to trade again. And then we're like, okay, good. It's over. Which hopefully in this video, I will show you where I think it might be. But also, like what I've said before on this channel is it's going to get really bad before it gets better. You have people calling to call to arms. I mean, when you have the left saying call to arms, the right, okay, yes, I understand. But the left, you know, things are going to get bad. And yes, they will. Just read that book, The Fourth Turning. Whenever, good little bedtime stories. But what I was saying, stocks will be in a bear market, right? Until one day. And that one day is when everything is just shaken to the core. Now, Gartman says a 6% drop. I say we know. And I say drop it like it's hot or till it's hot, until everyone leaves. Like what I've been saying, what goes up, right? And retail just doesn't understand this. What goes up must come down. I don't care about your narratives. I don't care about whatever. The Fed this, the Fed that. I trade what is in front of me. I trade charts and I know what a hockey stick looks like. And as the article, thank you for, did I get both? That's good, thanks. He advises investors, see? Big difference. And yes, as you know, I have, I am partially an investor, more so a trader. Although, and people are like, well, what, like TLT, that's in that long. My S&P, SPY, long, that's been, 20 to 25 years, just sits there. I'll see you later at some point. Oh, and that was like one of the only things that was going the other way yesterday was TLT. Oh my gosh. That would be the bond market. Actually, there was a huge today, booming auction. It's okay. Like everything, it will come to pass. And then I got to switch on that portfolio. It's all different. Swing trade, crypto. I'm going to get to that. You crypto kids, be scared. We have some broken rubber bands, some shenanigans. But he advises investors should be less involved, less long. Really? I mean, this is, it's a floor, right? It is a floor, right now. And when I say a floor, I mean you're finding a bottom. The floor is, it's not concrete. It's more like plastic or drywall. You jump on it enough, you're gonna fall to the next floor. But Gartman's like, you know what? I'm very wise. I reduce endowment stock exposures in February. Increased gold, which I love gold, but there are times that are, and everyone thinks, oh, let's move to gold. That plays not, it will not play well because when everyone hits the sell button, it takes gold and silver with it. And how about that bounce today? Look at this. And then now I'm going to get into the shenanigans. The Dow. Okay. It's okay. That looks like some green. I'll take that. The volatility is down today. Russell. Oh, put it on a 2% NASDAQ from the horrific sell-off. You get a bounce of two. But coming in, from how low do you want to go? Let me turn on, well, let me do two indicators for you. Let's go the 200, just so you can, this is the Dow Jones Industrial Average. If you would like to trade it, that would be DIA, which you can clearly see because it's way up there above my head. In blue. Now, financial advice, you will lose all of your money. But turning on one very simple indicator over that way. You see the blue and yellow? Okay. So where we are currently at, we're here. Okay. That red line. Do you see the price action? You see how many traders are in that? Not too much. So if you really want to know where you're going to catch people, that would be there. Also, if you're like, so scared, oh my gosh. Guys, we just recently fell below the 200. We've only moved down that far. That's not like this, okay? That was very far. And also, if you want to know what fixed this, okay, that would be trillions and trillions and trillions of bonds. Basically, that's you. That would be America giving up its future for now. Hey, can you fix that? So it was given to you like that. Also, I have to say, I don't like being on this side. I'm coming to the other side. It just kind of feels so backwards. But okay, so that's the Dow. You want to know what it looks like for the rest of the markets? Hold on. One moment. Here's your SPY, also known as your S&P 500. And see, ooh, lots of support, right? Not here. Now this is not your support zone. Also, see this blue line going like that? I said you break that. Oh no. And guess what? You kind of did. But it's okay, kids, because it's okay, retail traders, because the market will find a floor. It's just not going to be the floor you want it to be. And what do they say? One drinks, two drinks, three drinks, floor. Well, unless you're my my Russian Ukrainian wife who could drink everyone under the table. Sorry, she just came and she's like, it's Greek Ukrainian, not Russian. Greek, you, yes? Okay. How many fireball shots? Yell so they can hear it.
Nine.
And how'd you feel?
Great.
I mean, don't you use fireball to clean carburetors? What? Looking at the market, you have Netflix down over 71%. Oh, wait, I thought Diamond Hands and old markets only go up. Facebook, also a beta, 42%. Snap, you lost half. Tesla down 34%. Robinhood, are they delisted yet? No, they're still in the game. I don't know. I don't even know. Basically, when you see the chart like this and then just like kind of like, oh, can it go lower? And crypto, almost since yesterday, almost half. And I'll show you the scary news on crypto for those of you that are already all of your portfolio, half of all crypto portfolios, half underwater. You're like, hold on, there's more. U.S. retail. This is something that I mentioned. Sorry if the U.S. is cut off. Just trust me. It's not just S. Retail investors bought heavy. When did they buy heavy? Like a whole lot. That was Thursday. So Thursday of last week, they're like, all in. We're talking billions. How many? Almost 3 billion. This was one of the biggest dip buys ever. And then yesterday was one of the biggest dip buyers sell ever. And I say just swing trade. There's always, and that's why I have a watch list. I help you guys. This was on a 4-hour. I mean, this was on Smuckers. Who couldn't like Smuckers? shoot your insulin levels through the roof. This was the 400 above the 200. I know you're like, but it's a down day. See this little red line right there? I don't care. I mean, what was it from the bottom to top? I mean, if you took profit, you taking anything? What were we up on Smucker's? 6.68, not 666, 6.68. And I mean, you win some and you lose some, and that's okay. I've made, here's my second trade. Look, I'm going to make another trade. I got to close a position on a trade because it got a beat down, right? It went for the reversal and you petered out a little bit. So there you go. You win some, you lose some, but I'm not going to hodl. I mean, again, yes, if I have precious metals or if I have a bond or if I happen to buy oil at free, okay, I'm going to hold that. And here is your precious Bitcoin, which is playing out. Come on, you guys, like spot on, right? You're learning that the chart's actually, oh, and before I forget, 75% off. One day only because it is National Clean Your Room Day. That's today. So you can learn how to swing trade. And also, don't buy the course. And, you know, don't be like this. She clearly looks like a mom. This, you're enabling here. Right? Would you not? I had to zoom in on this. This is your kids having a Cinco de Mayo party, and you're cleaning up after them. I know people email like, I want to buy your swing trading course for my grand. Does your grandkid really want to do this? Do they really want to make money, or are you the one who wants to make? See, this is what you do. You do it, and then you can tell them, oh, so you want to have a new boat? Oh, you want to have a nice car? Oh, you want to? Oh, sorry, Buttercup, you got to work for it. So even though it is National Clean Up Your Finances Day, let's do this. You, take responsibility of your stuff. So that way you can come over here and you can go, hey, look, see? Look at this line. Look at this box that I've had. How long? How many years? I said, this is what's going to happen, right? Have I not? I mean, one time there's a bull flag way at the top. I'm like, is this a bull flag? Didn't play out. I'm like, sorry. Those two lines, see, here, I'll draw it for you so you learn what a bear flag is. Okay. See that? You see that? Uh-huh. Uh-huh. And I said, it's going to come right up here and smack its head on the 200-day moving average, which it did. And then I said, it's going to reject it if it does not hold that line. We're coming into the little gray box. And then I said, high probabilities. Okay. It's going to find support right there. Oh, hey, lo and behold, if for some reason you are an investor and you want to know, and I, this level, right? How much was that? That was 29,000. You put right click, you put in a buy order, you let it sit there, you wait till it gets filled. But now you want to know, but what's going to happen after this, Bravo? Well, I would love to help you with this. And let me turn on one thing. Yes, this is all in the course, and I use TradingView. This is different. You need to hold that drywall right there. Otherwise, guess what, kids? If you do not hold that area, this zone right there, this, it's going to cut through that like butter. I'm going to call that support levels, right? If you're an investor and you're like, this is a spot. Where would be another spot? 20K would be a spot. Okay. 10K would be a spot. Okay. If for some reason you're more of an advanced trader and you're like, I already did swing trading. My other course, CSU 197, three payments. You learn how to start businesses, swing trade. And then here is the, so this is, if you got a lot in your noggin, you already know how to trade, do the CSU. That is heavily focused on crypto, so you do not get recto. I personally don't like anything that even rhymes with recto or ends with an M. No, that is not me. You do you, not me. Here was a USD. This is where everyone moves their, I sell my Bitcoin. I move it into USD. It's supposed to stay at a dollar. Hey, kids. Hey, crypto kids. It's broken. Can you imagine? 68 cents. You thought, okay, safe. We're going safe. We're putting it in the dollar. You look at your portfolio, and you're down almost 40%. And 40% is a lot of money to lose. But again, you haven't seen the wheels fall off of the truck that's supposed to go round and round. And everyone, again, you know, like from the beginning, mainstream media, go, this is, buy the dip. How about now? Oh, God. Then it's you sell. Gosh, when do I sell? How about now? Okay. This was just yesterday. I love what, like, hold off on these stories. Just give me one day just so I can point these out. Okay, so last week, retail biggest buy the dip ever. Yesterday, retail is puking. This is the fifth biggest sell day on record. From whom? Retail. And I think retail treats the stock market like a casino. It's not. Like, the odds could be in your favor, but not if you play emotionally, where you're like, okay, we're all, yeah, right? The market, it's reversing all in. And then, oh my gosh, I just lost 60%. I'm all out. And I'm just trying to avoid you where that day comes. And you are not just all out. You're all out. Your credit card all out, which everyone's maxed out on that one. Your savings account, that's all gone. So please learn, I was going to say fundamentals. No, don't worry about, you have your fundamentals. You're like, okay, it's all about lines and probabilities. It is not about forward-looking PE ratios, because I can show those to all the Clorox. I can compare Clorox and NVIDIA, and Clorox beats it. No, I lied. NVIDIA beats it. So go all in on NVIDIA. Oh, hey, look, I lost all my money again. And also, like what I've been saying forever, a bear market. I called Bitcoin bear market when it was a long time ago. I've only said it, I think, once on this channel. Bear market, stock market, bear market. You're going to have ridiculous reversals, because bear market rallies are, oh my gosh, they'll pull retail in. So for those of you that don't understand how to do this and you missed the last run, we have so many runs to the down. And then we're going to have so many runs to the up. So please take advantage of the offers that I give you. Don't think of it like a casino. It is not. And if you do think it's a casino, well, you're going to lose everything. And also, so you don't lose me, can you click that? It helps the channel. It fixes the algorithm thing. And I will see you tomorrow.